Okay, setting up for that barbell deadlift, you want to remember, okay, that your pelvis is like a cup, all right? We don't want that cup to tip over any which way. So we always have to remember index finger thumb. Want that index finger to be running parallel with the floor. Okay, once you grasp that concept, we can move on further to our deadlift. So index finger parallel to the floor. Now from here, you're gonna get set up, shins up against the barbell. I like to take my feet about shoulder width stance. Then you're grabbing the barbell just outside shoulder width so that your hands have enough room to clear the knees. So going down, grabbing the barbell. From here, you're gonna twist the barbell out. Okay, so you're feeling, you're twisting like you're taking pinky to the thumb and thumb to the pinky. So it looks like this movement, okay? That's gonna engage our lats underneath of our armpit. So hands on the barbell, twisting out, drop my butt and pick up my chest. You'll hear that clang on the barbell. That just means that your arms are locked out and you're getting ready to pull. So I have tension in my upper back, tension in my lats on the sides of my back. And now the last thing I want to do before I pull is I want to get my butt set, okay? I want to put tension in my hamstrings. So I'm shooting my butt back just a little bit. Now you'll notice that my shoulders are going to be higher than my hips are going to be higher than my knees. Once you check all those things off, you can go ahead and pull. You're going to stand straight up and then lock out at the top, okay? You want to lock your glutes out, but you want to be careful to notice that we're standing nice and tall, we're nice and straight. Shoulders, hips, and knees are gonna be in alignment. We never wanna do this, okay? We don't wanna go in the opposite direction. So standing up nice and tall. Now when we're taking that weight back down to the floor, we're just reversing the motion. We're keeping everything still on tension, acting like I'm breaking this bar in half, push my hips back, and then I'm sitting down, okay? Now whenever I set that bar down, you'll notice that I didn't take my ribs, they didn't flare up in that open scissor position. I kept my core nice and tight as I was returning that bar to the ground.